Se solo la comunità che ci sono. But he said, y'all were nuts. Y'all were holding over and stuff. And he did ask me, he said, I'm trying to talk my wife into coming. He said, there ain't nobody in the board to grab a hold of her. She turns on me. And I said, absolutely. I said, no, you don't have to worry about that. We'll leave my friend later. And he says, me and my grandson are going to come, but I don't know if my wife's going to come or not. She probably scared somebody's going to grab a hold of her. So he is going to have to persuade her. You just come to church. So it's something that so many people want to, but there's something holding them back. So they have to be persuaded. Brother Billy. To be persuaded means to be won over. That's going to all be out. They were persuaded of the promises of God. Now we as a people, okay, you tell your kid that in the morning they're going to get a sucker every morning when they wake up. And every morning they're going to get a sucker. It ain't going to take long that it's going to work no more. That you're going to promise them a sucker to get up in the morning, and they're going to think you're the sucker. Huh? And you can get up every morning in the world and hold a lollipop right there in the living room. They ain't coming out of bed because they've been fooled too many times. Can I tell you that I'm persuaded in the promises of God? Because there ain't been one time he promised me something that he took back. There ain't been one time. I come to the house of God because I'm persuaded that I'm going to feel his presence when I come here. I come to the house of God because I'm persuaded somebody's going to be filled with the Holy Ghost when we come here. Been won over. I think I had come around to his way of thinking, so to speak.
Yeah.
I'm persuaded. The second thing is that they embrace his promises. I will embrace his promises. For they to say such things. They say, I'm persuaded of his promises. I've been won over. I'm a believer. And they say, I will embrace his promises. Which the embracing that they're talking about here is a hug of greeting. So anything to draw near, to grasp a hold. Brother Billy, the Bible says right here, they only saw the promises afar off. That's why we've got to get rid of this what have you done for me lately mentality and get our faith in the Word of God and in the promises of God. I told somebody the other day, I'm about to close. I talked to somebody the other day, talked to them all the way to St. Louis. Tuesday morning, up there. And time passes by. I enjoyed talking to him. Very good, close friend. A few years back, I talked to him. And at that point in time, he made more money by himself than the man I made him. Considerably more. Matter of fact, it was almost three times by himself when we met together. And Brother Billy, he was broke as a joke. Money was spent before he even got it. And now he ain't got a job. And he don't live no different than he was making all that money. And I told him Tuesday. This is going to wrap me up in a nutshell this morning. I told him. Because back then I asked him when he was making all that money. I said, are you, Brother Calvin? He said, can't afford to. Can't afford to pay. He's been raised in church too. He said, I can't afford to pay. I said, well, then God can't bless you. And won't be for God, knows the truth, has been Holy Ghost filled, walked away from God. And I finally told him Tuesday, I said, your life is no different whether you're making money or not. No different. So it ain't. So a lack of money is a problem. Because he was making 60-some thousand dollars a year. And when you went out on the road, you served in your car because you couldn't afford a hotel. Huh? And I told you back then that you just turned your life over to God. You didn't do it. And here we are, 7, 8, 9 years later, singing the same song and dance. I said, here's what happened, my friend. Is you refuse. You refuse to give in and be obedient and have faith in the promises of God. And when you do that, you handcuff God Almighty and you make it so that He cannot bless you. Because if you continue to be rebellious and you continue to be disobedient and He goes ahead and blesses you anyway, then He's alive. And He's not alive. The promises of God are in Him, yea, and in Him, amen. Your faith shouldn't stand in the wisdom of man, nor should it stand in the ignorance and stupidity of man. But it stands in the power of God. It stands in the power of God. And it's got to still stand there. Brother Pete, it stands there when I'm broke. It stands there when I don't have any groceries. It stands there when the cupboard is full. It stands there when I'm walking to work. It stands there, listen to me, it stands there when my kids are ashamed of me. Listen to me. I used to drive a little big old Ranger pickup. I got made fun of by, they said I look like a Donkey Kong. My kids were ashamed. Because I'd be coming to pick them up from ball practice, Brother Billy, and they said, Dad, we can hear you coming blocks away. Everybody turns and says, there comes your dad.
Faith in that, this ain't me.
What's y'all seeing, this ain't really me. Really me is when you wait till God gets done with it. Oh, now. You wait till God. You need to practice saying that. Get up in the morning and say it. Instead of saying, I know I ain't where I ought to be. I know I'm not right. Say it. Self, you ought to see me when God gets done with it. Because if you're coming to the house of God, you're getting up in the morning and you're getting yourself ready, you're coming to the house of God, you're talking about how good the Lord is. Brother Keene, yesterday I run into somebody. They said, Bull Keene's bragging on you. What are you saying? The next words out of my mouth, Sister Virginia, was, you ought to come to go too. And she said, I'm going to.
That's right.
What are you saying, ladies and gentlemen? Are you saying the sky's falling? Are you saying, today might be tough, but you wait till in the morning?
Right.
Huh? I'm going through a struggle right now. But if I can wait till Sunday morning and get to the house of God, if I can get there Wednesday, I'm going to hear a sure word, a prophecy, Brother Billy, and it's like a light that shines into a dark place.
Yes,
this darkness that sometimes I got wrapped up in myself, and if I'm not careful, Sister Maria, I have to go down there and repent because it ain't been faith coming out of my mouth, Brother Billy. And I got to be reminded that I serve a God that made this world. That's my God.
Amen.
Chris, that's my God. Brother McKinney, that's my God. Honey, that's my God.
Yes.
He ain't never done me nothing but good.
Amen.
He ain't never done me nothing but good.
Amen.
Stand with me right now, if you would. What are you saying?